Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh, good morning. Good morning. Welcome to Cawdor Castle.
Oh, it's lovely.
Yeah. We're just enjoying it. Have you been here before again?
No.
Not ever. No. It's quite quiet this morning, so you kind of lose quiet. Thank you.
crusaders.
Just going to say to you folks, this fireplace is the most important thing in the room. Seems a bit silly. It was put in 1671 in recognition of the only fainess of Cawdor, the only female was a fain of Cawdor. And this was Muriel Cawdor. She was born in 1498. Her parents died the same year. She was instantly an orphan, and she was also instantly near us to the biggest tract of land in the Highlands. So instantly, many clan chiefs were after her, even at that age. So the king at the time said she could no longer live here in Cawdor. On with servants, she had to move to another castle where there were relatives. But she had three uncles through marriage living in a castle 4 miles up the road, Kilbock, the Rose family. So she and the wet nurse went to stay with them. They were concerned that the Campbells of the Guy might come and steal her. So they asked the wet nurse to mark her so they could recognise her in later years. So the wet nurse took a brass key out of the fire and branded her on the hip, leaving a full impression of the key. As the uncle said, well, that tells us nothing because we won't see that if it's over. So the wet nurse then took her left hand and just put the top of her finger and just right at the knuckle, second knuckle, just took it straight off and sealed it with that peat out of the fire. That was her chapel care in 1498. So a few weeks later, the Campbells came across as a bit of a battle between both families. They kidnapped Muriel and took her off to her Inverness castle in Argyll, the home of the Duke of Argyll. And they kept her there till 1510, when she was 12 years of age, which is the marrying age in Scotland. So he then married her off to the third son of the Earl of Argyll. And instantly, as it was up till late 1800s, the wife loses everything and it becomes that. So then the Campbells effectively had the Cawdor estates, over 100,000 acres and a castle. Wow. So this was put here in recognition of Muriel because she came back to live here when she was 24. She didn't have any children at that time, but from the age of 24, she had definitely 9 children, possibly as many as 13. There's a bit of a dispute in the figures. It was a very loving marriage. So in recognition of that, a fame in 1671 put this up. And you'll see the S on the top, that's for Sir. There's an I to the left, it's actually a J, that's how they did J's in those days. That's right. John Campbell, who married the last true Cawdor, that's M.C., Muriel Cawdor. And she outlived all the family, died here when she was 87, which in the 1500s was amazing. Yeah. So he, and a late Earl, our Earl, who wrote all the notes as you go around and the things you're listening to, was very tongue-in-cheek, and he called her a tough old bird, and I think he was probably right.
Definitely right.
And the, at the bottom there, the Latin saying is supposed to be to the effect of, in the morning you remember your maker. The late Earl preferred to say that should you stay late in the evening, you would regret it in the morning. I'll leave you with that. Okay,
for my story, thank you.